Hi everyone, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I track my time inside Notion. So in order to add a new action that I want to track, I just click here in time tracking and I describe what I'm doing. So for instance, like I'm saying Notion video, that's a note about the action that I want to track. And then I link it to a deliverable. In this case, I'm going to be searching to the deliverable. So this is going to be a YouTube video. And then as you can see, we have the deliverable, so making a YouTube video. And then we have associated to that deliverable a project. Then this new action is as a status of not started. When I press start here, this shows in progress. Another great thing that is done automatically, but I'm not displaying in this page here, is that it has added a start time. So if now I press on stop, after a few minutes, let's say that I've worked on this task, the action actually disappears from there because here I want to track only the action that have not started or are in progress. But if I go into time tracking, my table, here you can see the number of minutes that I've worked on the Notion video. You can see the project, you can still see the start and the stop button. So if I want to adjust it, let's say that I work a few minutes more on this task, I can still press stop and this is going to update the stop time. And also we have the start time. So if I made a mistake or retroactively, I want to add an action, let's say that this started 20 minutes ago, but unfortunately I forgot to press start or to create this action inside Notion, then I can just simply change the time and I say 5:28, press enter, and this shows the minutes work here calculated. I think this is super simple and super effective because it allows you to track the actions that you are working on very simply inside Notion. You just have to press on the start and stop button and just write a short note about the action that you want to track, and you have to link it with a deliverable and a project. But also the thing that I love is that it's super simple to edit the time if retrospectively you want to change and you want to update that information. Let me show you also a very cool thing that you can do after you keep tracking of this time. And this is using Python. So for instance, you can create this type of charts in which I'm seeing my weekly workload. I'm tracking throughout the weeks. So week 8, week 7, week 9, week 10, week 11. I can see how much time I've worked per week. So if I go over the week 10, I can see that I've worked 40 hours. And here inside these boxes, I can see what took most of my time. And here, going back inside Notion, I'm actually grouping by the deliverable, okay? So this is one of the charts that you can create. So for instance, here I can show that I work for 3 hours on answering emails. But of course, you're not limited to that type of chart. Here, for instance, I am showing a stack bar plot in which I'm actually showing the tag associated with that specific deliverable, and then I can see how many hours I work on different things. So I think this is very effective. In today's video, we are going to be covering just how to create that table where you can track the time. But then if you want, and if you're interested, let me know and I can also share the Python code that I wrote to generate this chart. So before we start, and I'm going to explain you how to create that table, or actually is a database inline to track your time, let me just quickly explain what are deliverables and what are project. So I structure my work in this way. So each time I need to do a project, so for instance, the SMA paper is the Sports and Medicine Australia Policy. We are working on the paper, but also we have other deliverables, which could be the application and so forth. So I have a project, which is what I want to achieve. So I want to create version 2. And then as a subset, I have deliverables that I'm working on. Okay, so this is just an example and this is how I structure it. If you want, I can create another video and I can better explain how I structure my work. But I have an overarching project and then as a subset, I have deliverables, which could be collect the data, write the paper, and then prepare the presentation for the conference. Okay, so these are the deliverables. And these, for instance, are my project. So here we can see that, for instance, I have the cozy application that I've developed or the climate tool. I associated each project with a tag also to the workplace that is associated with. And sometimes it could be associated to multiple places. For instance, the climate tool is associated both with Berkeley and with Simberbest. So I hope this makes sense because we are going to add later a connection in the time tracking from the action that we want to track to the deliverable and to the project. The other things that I really like of this approach that I'm going to show you is that database for time tracking is not mixed at all with deliverable database and the project database. So each one is independent, and this is going to be very helpful also when you're exporting the data, but also is going to be very helpful when you're searching for deliverables because those are not mixed up with the actions that we want to track and with the project. I hope this makes sense, and if it does not, leave a comment to the video. So let's go and let me explain step by step how I created that very nice time tracking that only works by clicking a button. Before we start, if you think this video interesting, I just would like to ask you to like the video and subscribe to my channel. As usual, if you have any questions about my video, you can leave a question down in the comments below. Also, leave a nice comment if you enjoyed the video. That will be much appreciated. So let me show you how to create that inline database to keep track of the time that I'm spending on specific deliverables. So the first thing, in a new page here, we have to put /, and then we're going to say inline database. This is going to create a view table, and we're going to call it time tracking for video YouTube. Okay, this is just a name. So name will contain the description of the task that I'm working on. The second thing that we want, for instance, we don't want a tag here, so we can delete this one here. But what we want is to link to the deliverable. So we are going to be clicking on this plus button here, and then we scroll down here and we're going to click on relation. We're going to relate it to the deliverable database. So basically we're going to say no limit and then we're going to add relation. So let's start typing and we're going to say YouTube video about Notion, and then deliverable are going to be YouTube videos. It would also be nice if here we could see also the associated project. That can be done using a rollup. So again, we just have to press the plus button and then we press on rollup, and then we're going to say type rollup relation, we're going to select to deliverable. And then we're going to say property, we are going to see as project. Because YouTube videos are associated to the project, which is YouTube. So then we are going to be adding a couple of more information. Okay, so here we want to add a plus again, and we want to add a button. So this button is going to be start. And then this other button, so we're going to create another button here. And this is, we're going to call it stop. Soon we are going to be associating an action when the button is clicked. So here we are going to add a new column to this table, which is a date. So we want to be a date, a full date, and time format, well, it's up to you. I like the 24 hour. So this is when our action is going to start, and we're going to be updating this with the start button. and then we're going to add a new one, again, a date, and we are going to be calling this one stop time. Before I made a mistake, so this is not date, but this is start time. So perfect. Now what we need to do is to change the action associated with the start button. So we click here at the top, we click on edit property. So we make sure that this says start and then label start. And then here we say when button is clicked, we scroll down here, we say add an action. We are going to say that we are going to edit this property. So start time equal to now. So if I press start, as you can see, is the 23rd, 2024, 18.04. Now, the same thing that we need to do is with the stop time, or the stop button, sorry. So we click here, we click on edit property, label, we're going to call it stop. Okay, it doesn't really need because it gets the same number at the top. And then we're going to add an action, and then we can say stop time, and then we're going to say now. So let's go here and then now click stop. This is perfect. However, we can see that just the time format is not correct. So we're going to click here, edit property, and we're going to change this to 24 hour. Fantastic. So we can already see that we have almost everything that we want. So let's make them these just a little bit smaller so everything fits on our screen. So also in the button, a nice thing that if you click on edit property, here you can also add an emoji, okay? So on Mac is FNE, and then I can say start, and I can pick an emoji that I like, and this is the emoji that I want to pick, and now you can see that the label of the button actually has an emoji, which is nice, just if you want. And then the same thing you can do later on for the stop button. Now, we have to also add, if we want, a status here, and then we are going to calculate the time that it took to complete that action. But the time that it took is going to be very simple because it's just a simple equation that we just have to write inside Notion. So now let's add a formula which we can use to calculate the minutes worked on this specific task. So we click here and then we scroll down and we click on formula. Now we have to edit the formula. And I've already wrote this one. So we have two numbers. So we want to create a number and then we have to use this format. And then basically the calculation is date between. Let me cancel this and we can actually get it from here. So stop time. And then here we are going to get the start time. Start time, fantastic, in minutes. Okay, so we're going to press done. We can see that is already a number, so you can have it as a number or you can have it as a bar or a ring. So let me just show you how it will look as a number, as a ring, and then you can change it as you want. So actually I don't like the ring, so we can easily go back here in the formula, edit property, and we're going to use this bar. I like it more. And again, as I showed you before, let's say that I'm now happy, but I'm still working on this task, so I've already stopped it. This doesn't stop me to repress stop right now, so you can see that now I work on this task for 5 minutes. And again, we can also retroactively change this one, and we can say, for instance, from 5, I was working on this, and this gets updated. Of course, it doesn't have to be in minutes, it can also be in hours, and that's up to you to change that formula if you want to. For instance, you can get this number divided by 60. And also, you can also select what is the maximum value. Here, since a day, a working day, is basically 60 minutes in 2 8-hour in where I work, this could be 480 instead of being 100. And this is going to be like, see, 65 out of 480. So this is basically what I work throughout the day. Let's add that label with the status. So here we are going to add a new one with, we are going to create like a status here. And we have not started, in progress, or done. So let's say not started, we use it in yellow. The last thing, only the last thing that we need to do is to click on the button here, and then we're going to edit property. So when the button is clicked, we are going to edit the start time, but we are going to add another step here. So we are going to say that the status is in progress. And the same that we need to update is for stop. We're going to click on edit property. When the button is clicked, we are going to add another step and we're going to say that the status is done. Let's see if it's working. So let me press start and actually shows in progress, which is fantastic. And then we press stop and it is actually done. So we can delete these few new row and let's create another one. And let's say edit the video. And again, it's still related to this deliverable, which is YouTube videos. And then this is going to be associated again to the rollup, which we can also change it, this name, and could be the project. And then we can press start. Now you can see that this is in progress. A nice thing is that when the activity is created by default, it just basically shows not started. This table is going to be very long. And in this summary here, I just want to see the action that I'm actually working on. I don't want to see them all. I want to basically then analyze this in another page. So what I'm doing here, the last thing is I'm doing filter here, and I'm going to say for status, and status is, we can actually say in progress or not started. So here we keep track of only the activity that are actually in progress or I'm planning to work. So this is also a very nice thing because for the day you can say answer email and then you can say like write paper. So here you can actually keep track, and this is what I do, of the action that I want to get done for that specific day. Then when I click stop, the action goes away, but is of course not lost. So you just have to go here inside summary page. You have the basically table and you can create another view. And then this one is a new view, which is all, let's call it. And this one shows all of them. The one that are done, the one that are in progress, and the one that have not started yet. So here is where actually you can keep track of all the things that you have done. The last thing that you need to do if you want to export this data and for instance import them in Python is click on these three dots here at the top and then you can do export. And this is going to export this table as a CSV on your computer. I really hope you find this video informative and useful. If you did, please consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel. Thank you very much for listening, and if you have any question, please leave it in the comment section down below. If you feel very generous and if you really think that this video has helped you a lot, please consider buying me a coffee or supporting me on Patreon. More information down in the video description below. Thank you very much for listening and have a great day.